Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Some lessons can't be taught.
Thank you so much for being here this evening.
They must be learned. So on a fall night in Austin, it's the first day of class.
Good evening, everyone.
Its name, Right on Race, a two-year course exploring housing, healthcare, education, criminal justice.
There's a lot of material in there.
Life through the lens of race.
I had an aha moment, I guess.
Nancy Fitzsimmons says she's a different person than when she took the class 5 years ago.
I never really made that connection before.
She spent months studying and journaling as part of the first ever Right on Race group and says being vulnerable and honest about such painful topics changed her in unexpected ways.
As a human being, it was quite transformative to be a part of it.
Transformative because she'd never known about things like redlining, achievement gaps, sundown towns. Like most others in the class, never thought about what it meant to be totally unaware of race. Was it uncomfortable?
It sure was. The first time I heard white privilege, I didn't care for it. I've heard the term before, but I had to sit with that the night that we talked about white privilege and then let it impact me.
What we can feel in our heart is how we can really make some change.
That impact is exactly why Bukata Hayes and Stacey Wells started Right on Race. Long before Minnesota became the epicenter of racial justice, they saw and lived these issues and say our state is not as progressive as many of us believe.
It seems really nice and liberal and welcoming, but there are things that people of color, particularly black people, experience every day that don't get talked about, right? We just sort of deal with it.
But they wondered how that might change, how their own friends and neighbors might change, if first they learned and then they led.
Each time we just saw people sort of grow a little bit more in their confidence around race. Not that it was easy for them, but just that they started noticing things and were calling things out and had more questions.
Every Minnesotan, I believe, is duty-bound to be part of the solution. So no longer can we simply be well-intentioned and want to learn. I think we have to be well-intentioned. We need to learn and grow and actually act.
I watch the news much differently now. I read much differently as a result of what I learned through Right on Race.
Back in Austin, the new group is already feeling that difference.
I see myself as an American, but most of the time, sorry. I feel like when people ask me where I'm from, 80% of the time they don't accept that the answer is Austin. And they just see my skin, my hair, my eyes, and just see me as an outsider.
Hayes and Wells say it's moments like this they hope will inspire people to alone change themselves.
We think it is so important to actually feel this, right?
And then together, the world.
You're going to be a part of making this a better world for your grandkids and your great-grandkids, so maybe we don't have to keep reliving history. And I think that's pretty powerful.
Janelle Klein, Care 11 News.
Well, Right on Race may soon be coming to your hometown. The founders are working with the Minnesota Humanities Center to expand the program to Rochester, Duluth, Mankato, and St. Cloud.